Hi Aries, welcome to my channel. This is Nina. Thank you for tuning in with me today. This is your love story reading for the next 3 to 4 weeks. We're looking at what's playing out between you and somebody special. And this could be anyone, okay? It doesn't matter if you're single or you're seeing someone. It could be the energy of the person you have already dealt with, you are currently dealing with, or someone you are likely to come across, okay? So keep an open mind and don't force the messages to apply to you, okay? Take whatever resonates and leave the rest behind. So I'm going to start with your tarot cards. And whilst I was shuffling your cards and getting ready for your reading, I was hearing, take it easy with this one, okay? So if you are just getting to know somebody, I feel like it's going to be advisable for you to take it slow with this person, okay? And to not rush into anything, alright? And if you're already dealing with someone, maybe there's a situation that is yet to play out, and that's the advice for you to take it easy, alright? Let's see. So for the Two of Swords, okay. Nine of Cups. Knight of Pentacles, yeah. Pretty slow person actually. Five of Swords, alright, that's a surprise. And the Chariot. And the Sun, okay. Let's get your cards out. We have the Seven of Swords at the bottom of the deck. I've just noticed that. So something is probably going on beneath the surface that you are not aware of, possibly, okay. Four of Wands, okay. The Tower, oh my god, okay. And the Eight of Pentacles, and we take that, the Hierophant, alright. And Justice, and the Knight of Wands, okay. Now we have the Death card at the bottom of the deck, alright. So, let's get some Lenormand cards out and we'll understand this better. But it feels to me like something's gone down, okay? For most of you, this is somebody that you have already maybe broken up with, but you're still thinking about it. You might be focusing on your work right now whilst still thinking of them at the back of your mind, okay? And you're kind of waiting to charge forward, to move along, okay, with this person. But what's interesting is that you've got the Justice card here. Let me just adjust the camera. Okay, you've got the Justice card here as your intention and your most likely action. And they've got the Two of Swords there, and both of them kind of talk to me about, you know, needing to decide, needing to make a choice, a decision, weighing the pros and cons, and looking at things logically, and wanting to play it fair, okay? It feels to me like this person is right now not communicating with you. There's blocked communication. But slowly but surely, this person is realizing that you make them happy, okay? And what they want to do, at least what they're intending to do, is come towards you, overcoming all the challenges and, you know, trying to forget all the disagreements and fights maybe that you've had. And they want to come towards you, all right? And maybe like start over, start anew with the Sun energy, also heal the connection, okay? Now you might be quite focused on your work and your home situation for whatever reason, okay? And your own personal commitments. deep down, I feel like you still are, like, if this is someone known, this is someone that you are still, you know, at the back of your mind, you are still committed to. But you're trying to distract yourself with work, okay? And actually, you want to make this work as well with this person. But at the same time, you are a bit disturbed about something that's gone down. And so what you're doing instead is you're kind of holding back on your passions. You're trying to look at the situation from a more logical perspective. Now, Aries is quite impulsive in nature, which would explain the Knight of Wands there. But what you're doing is you're holding up your Sword of Truth with the Justice card, and you're being very you're being very diplomatic, you're being quite, you know, you're observing the situation is kind of what I'm getting, alright? Like, let's see how this plays out. So you've got the Ring, the Book, and the Coffin, and the Birds, okay. There's something hidden, like deep within this person that they want to communicate, and that is likely, you know, their commitment, their partnership with you. That is what they want to discuss about with you, okay? We've got the Whip. Yeah, something's gone down. Could be a fight, you know, something that you may have even realized about this connection. Okay, so it looks like both of you want to communicate. And we have the Anchor now at the bottom of the deck. I like seeing that. It looks like you both want to air things out in the open and, you know, sort of speak your mind, speak your heart, have a heart-to-heart conversation and talk about things that you've both sort of buried until now, okay? And you seem to even understand something or learn something that was previously hidden. Now, for those of you where you're discovering something about this person, you know, that maybe I'm not really seeing a third party situation or anything like that, but there's something that you are discovering, some truth that you want to get an honest conversation going on about, okay? And so you've got the Rider here as well as the Knight of Wands. You're intending to communicate, to move towards this person, to approach them, and to air out whatever's been bottled up is what I'm feeling, okay? Because with the Whip there, it's like a forceful action as well, and it's confrontational in nature. So it feels to me like you kind of want to confront this person about what happened, not maybe in an aggressive manner, but like air out your differences is what I'm getting. So you've got outside influences, got chemistry, okay, third party, and we have trust issues. At the bottom of the deck, we have deception. Now, I don't know what that deception could be, but to me, this feels like there's somebody else who might be meddling in this connection, who might be even giving this person a hard time about your relationship with them, okay? And I'm not really sensing this third party to be like another woman or another man. It could simply be that they have other commitments that they need to work on. They have their own goals and priorities in mind, okay? But they are thinking of approaching you, but rather slowly is what I'm seeing, okay? Maybe it's a bit of a game that they're playing, because the Five of Swords is a bit of, you know, immature energy. Somebody who's got like mommy issues or daddy issues would want to have the upper hand, want to be the winner at all costs, you know, that sort of a thing. We have the Page of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck and the Three of Swords. Okay. I feel like you might not actually trust this person. So, And I can understand why, because they don't really open up, they don't really speak, I feel, okay? And there's definitely something that they are suppressing. but they are also healing. They are wanting to let go and move on, okay, to a better situation. So let's see where this is heading between you and this other person. So we have the Eight of Wands, Page of Wands, definitely communication coming through. Okay, let me use another deck and ask, what is this communication about? What's this communication about? Two of Swords, okay. So they have the Two of Swords as their energy. Ten of Cups. King of Wands, okay. Knight of Pentacles, so that's a repetition. They definitely have that on their mind, okay. I feel like you're going to have to take things slow with this person. They will approach you. There is going to be communication and possibly a reconciliation. But I am seeing the Ten of Cups and the Ten of Pentacles here. So for some of you, there is possibly a situation going on, you know, and the Three of Cups. It is quite possible that this person is committed somewhere else, okay, and that's why they are maybe resisting your charms, or there's been misunderstandings between you all. For those of you where this person is likely married, it is quite possible that they finally make that decision, they make a call and they approach you, okay. Now we've got Death at the bottom of the deck. So tell me more about this. Okay. Too many. What's likely to happen? Ace of Swords. So more communication. Ace of Cups. Wow. Alright. So, and Death. There is going to be a change, okay? The ending of something. Now, either you already have a suspicion. There are two scenarios here. Either you already have a suspicion that this person has somebody else in their life who they are committed to, and finally they blot it out, they communicate with you, you have a heart-to-heart conversation and you release this situation, you let it go, and that's when you open up to this possibility of new connections coming your way, alright? Because we have two aces here, that's definitely a brand new start from a fresh clean slate, okay? And the Knight of Pentacles is also an offer, somebody approaching you, alright? Now, if this person is not married or whatever, or even if they are and you want to actually seriously consider this option, okay, this connection, it's possible that they finally make that decision, that call, and they approach you with this offer of, you know, commitment, you could say, a fresh start, and wanting to take things further, alright? But I can't help but notice that we have the Three of Cups and the Death card at the bottom of the deck. Something will definitely need to change if that is the case, and they will have to come clean is what I'm hearing, alright? So something's been playing out definitely, which you, I feel, have an inkling about. You have an intuition about what's going on. And that may be that epiphany, that realization that you have, that you want to confront this person about, okay? So what is the advice here for Aries? Be authentic. Be real and true to who you are and how you feel. Look to your inner strength. You're stronger than you realize. Love endures. Love does not give up or lose faith. Love is hopeful and withstands every situation. Take a chance on love. Now, maybe this person already has like a family and they are actually separated, okay? But then what happens is that from time to time you start being suspicious of them and you don't trust them. And so you're like, they're gonna, you have probably this insecurity that they're gonna get up and, you know, go back to that person anytime. That is something that you will need to be honest about and be authentic about. If it's bothering you, air it, speak about it, okay? Be willing to express. And if that, and that would involve you taking a chance on love. But if it's something that you don't want to compromise on, it's bothering you, it's affecting your mental health, then maybe you want to release this and open up to new possibilities, which are definitely on the horizon for you. So what can they expect or look forward to in their love life? Next 3 to 4 weeks, what can Aries look forward to? Forgiveness. Spiritual connection. Wow, I wasn't expecting that. And the only thing that is real is love. A choice will need to be made. A decision will need to be made. Receive with love and appreciation. Gracious acceptance is a way to show love. So I feel like you're going to accept the situation for what it is and forgive this person for, you know, whatever they are putting you through or already have put you through. And there is going to be forgiveness and healing. And whether you decide to stay with them or not ultimately depends on how authentically you both present yourself and how this conversation goes, okay? Because it could go either way. It could either end in a separation, in a, you know, a dead end, or it could and you finding closure in that, or it could actually transform and lead to something that is, you know, an even deeper connection. Alright, so that is what I have for you, Aries. Interesting reading. I hope you enjoyed it. If it made sense to you, if you enjoyed it, please hit the like button and let me know. I'm wishing you all the very best. Do take care of yourself and please subscribe to the channel if you haven't. I'll see you again later. Bye bye.